This is a real wearable Iron Man hand, and unlike every other one online, this one is fully metal 3D printed. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I made it, how you can bring your ideas to life in metal, and how this gets us one step closer to a full metal Iron Man suit in real life. But this isn't actually my first time making an Iron Man hand.
Mateo Jarquin, soon to represent Canada at the International Science Expo with his project Flex, started his journey at a young age when he bought himself his first 3D printer. His first ever project was making his very own 3D printed Iron Man hand.
So one could say it was the project that started it all.
This is the original, the very first Iron Man hand I ever made. It was 3D printed in plastic, had a working LED, flexible fingers so I could move my joints, and even a speaker so I could play the repulsor sound effect. I decided to create this project to challenge myself and build something more technical, but this little project ended up being so much more than just a prop. It's what started my entire engineering journey. So I wanted to come back to where it all began and rebuild this project the way Tony Stark would have done it. Not in plastic, but in real metal. So I had to completely redesign the glove to fit my hand perfectly again. Only this time, I have experience. When I made the first Iron Man hand, I was still learning how to model, and it was the first time I ever soldered wires. One thing I learned along my journey is to always make a test print, a thin slice of your project to make sure it'll actually fit before you print the entire object. To make this project a reality, I partnered with JLC 3DP, the future of manufacturing, with their 3D printing services. I can't be the only one who's wanted to recreate their projects out of metal, and their online platform allows for an easy upload of 3D models so you can get instant quotes on your very own models. All you have to do is select your material, which ranges from flexible plastics to stainless steel, and they will manage every step, from production to delivery within 5 days. Their services start at 3 cents, and new users can get up to $70 coupons with the link in my description. So check out what they can do for you. Now that I have the parts, the next step is to make them that reflective silver. For that, I went to my grandparents' house to get to spray painting. All I used was a good coat of primer and reflective chrome. My grandfather actually helped me out with the original hand, so I was happy to do this with him again. After the spray painting, I glued each part of the fingers to an elastic and attached them to the main hand. I decided to upgrade the LEDs, and the wiring guide is super simple and beginner friendly, so here's how it works. The power supply of this project is a 9-volt battery. First, I connected the red wire to one side of the push button. Then I took the black wire and soldered it directly to the 9-volt LED. And finally, you connect a new wire to the other side of the push button and connect that one to the positive side of the LED. And now you have an LED that turns on when it's pushed. This works for all lights, by the way. To hold the back piece in place, I created this Velcro band and attached a magnet. The only thing left was figuring out how to get this new light into the old hand design. Luckily, I had some help. You there, Jarvis?
Welcome back. How may I be of assistance?
Make me a ring, and give its outer diameter 27.8 millimeters, and inner diameter 19.5.
Rendering now.
It's done printing. This ring should stabilize it. The last thing to do is to put the push button right under here. That way you can press the button just by opening your hand. And now, the moment I've been waiting for. And that's the story of my very first project. If you want to see how this project led to me making a groundbreaking robotic arm, make sure to check out my Flex video. Even though remaking my first ever project seems like a full circle moment for me, this is just the beginning. And if you want to see more projects like this one, I actually post behind the scenes updates and connect with other makers on Arc, which is basically a social media platform, but for creators and inventors. Think of it like an Instagram, but for engineers. It's available for free on the App Store or Google Play, and I'll leave a link to it below. I also really wanted to spread the word about this possible science fair-styled maker competition, where whoever wins gets a free Bamboo Lab H2D 3D printer. So make sure to check it out, as I would love to see your guys' creations. By the way, I'm aware that the Hacksmith has created a metal Iron Man gauntlet in the past, but their method involved laser cutting and folding the stainless steel plates, whereas according to my research, this is the first time that someone has ever used metal 3D printing to create Iron Man armor. And the precision that comes with using metal 3D printing is just incredible. If you guys want to be part of the Mateo Tech Lab community, I've also set up a Discord server where we share ideas, prototype, and sometimes even collab on crazy builds. So come hang out with us on Arc or Discord. I'd love to see what you're working on too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next build.